Okay. We are live. Oh wait. We are.
We are.
Oh. Where are
Just
the things with the people?
we will see it as soon as they start coming on.
Oh, okay.
So no one's here.
Yeah, no. But hopefully people will start coming on soon. For those who don't know, oh, there we go. We got Jennifer and Cynthia just joined us. There we go. We're starting to have people
Yay.
Join the conversation.
Not just our mom.
For those, yeah, not just our mom. Hi, mom. For those who are joining us, let us know in the comments maybe where you're from, and if you've already started doing anything for Balance Awareness Week, we'd love to kind of hear what you're doing just to raise awareness in your local community in the comments. I think we're going to wait maybe a minute or two just to let people get on and join the conversation. So we're excited to be here.
Yeah. Hi, guys. Hi, Linda.
And Brandy. Got Brandy here.
Brandy.
I'll pop on here so I can also check comments as we go.
How are you guys doing today? How are you feeling? Good?
Is everybody having a dizzy day? Or are we feeling good today? In Texas, it's, I don't know, how hot is it right now?
It's really hot.
It's 95 degrees, so it really does not feel like fall here.
How are you feeling?
I'm doing okay.
Good.
How are you doing, Alicia?
Good. I'm having a pretty good day.
We're also sporting our migraine glasses, so, you know, vestibular migraine girls over here. Okay, well, we can probably start chatting as we let people get on here. Looks like we have a lot of people coming in here. Oh, from Charleston, South Carolina. Got New York. Oh, dizzy day, too. Well, we hope that all of this will just make you guys feel better as we talk about ways that we can raise awareness during Balance Awareness Week.
Yeah.
So, do you want to start, Alicia?
So Balance Awareness Week is September 15th through the 21st, and the hashtag for it is All Can Fall, and also Balance Awareness Week 2019. And Balance Awareness Week is something that VITA does every year to bring awareness to vestibular disorders. And this is for all types of vestibular disorders, from Meniere's disease to vestibular migraine, which we both have, to vestibular neuritis, anything that you guys are probably dealing with. That's what VITA is covering with Balance Awareness Week. And it's the purpose of it is to get others to understand what it's like to live in a world without balance and what it feels like every day for people like us.
Right.
We all know how hard it is to explain, like, to our family members and even sometimes to our doctors. Sometimes our doctors don't understand. So the more awareness that we can bring to vestibular disorders, the better off we'll be. It will mean better treatments for us. You know, better doctors, which we all need, and overall better awareness for our vestibular disorders. So hopefully more funding, more research into it, and, you know, overall, hopefully it'll be a better thing for all of us.
Right, exactly. As Alicia was saying, we both have vestibular migraine. I was diagnosed, it's been 3 years, it was October of 2016, and it took probably about 6 or 7 months till I got a diagnosis and started seeing our doctor, Dr. Bay. So just the fact that even, I think, 3 years, there's so much more out there than there was when I first got diagnosed. Like, there's people are talking about it now. You can even go, like, on Instagram and search hashtag vestibular migraine, and there is a plethora of information.
There wasn't. Like, when we first started this, there wasn't anything out there.
No, not at all.
Just VITA really was the pioneer for all of this.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah.
That's how I started realizing I was not alone.
Yeah. And that's how we met, too.
Yeah.
So it's a great resource, like, for people to find support groups, for education, and just to not feel so alone.
Mm-hmm.
Like, mine started about the same time as Kayla's, and so that's how we connected, was through some of VITA's resources. But it took both of us several doctors to finally get a diagnosis, and we were misdiagnosed several different times.
I'm actually curious, if anyone wants to write in the comments, how many doctors did you see?
Yeah.
No matter, like, what your diagnosis was at the end, how many doctors did you see till you figured out what it is that you have?
Yeah.
just be curious to see that.
But that's why Balance Awareness Week is so important, because the more attention we can bring to these disorders and educate even other physicians, like, the better resources that we'll have.
Absolutely.
And, you know, the faster people can get diagnosed too. You don't have to wait, you know, 6 months like we did to get any help. And, you know, I lost my job to it. I know several of you probably have too. And a lot of that time was waiting on disability when you don't have a diagnosis is really difficult.
I mean, I'm even seeing on here, someone just said that they were misdiagnosed for 10 years.
Oh my gosh.
I can't even imagine that. Even just from the 6 to 7 months that I went through a misdiagnosis for 10 years. That's why this is just so important to raise awareness.
So, so important. So how can you get involved, basically, is our next point.
Right.
You may think, you know, we both have our sites and we talk about how we deal with our vestibular migraine, how we explain this to family and friends, how we've been treated. But if you don't have a website or, you know, an Instagram or anything like that, what can you do to get involved? So we have some tips for you.
Right, exactly. I mean, like she was just saying, you know, it was therapeutic for me at first to write about my story, and that's why I started blogging about it. But, you know, writing is just something that's like always been a therapeutic thing for me. And if that's not maybe what's like your forte, there's just simple things that you can do just by even following Vita on Facebook and liking and sharing their posts. Do you realize that anytime you like something on Facebook, that's going to show up in your friends' feeds? Sorry, marketing hat here. I'm a marketing girl, but anytime you like anything on Facebook, that's going to show up in your friends' feeds. So anytime you interact with anything without even knowing it, you're sharing that to a bunch of different people. So that's really imperative, especially next week, to just engage with the content that Vita's even putting out there.
And also Facebook, like their algorithms, even for Instagram and Facebook, the more you like stuff, the more it gets shared with, you know, other people that you may not see. So maybe someone else needs to hear it or see it, and Facebook will recognize it as a popular post and
right.
share it with more people.
Right. There are other things that you can do too on Vita's website. That's one of the first things I did when I first got diagnosed is I added myself to the Vita patient spotlight so that I could even just discuss my story. And it's kind of a cool outlet for you just to kind of be able to talk about what your story is and how your journey got you to where you're at today. And it might help somebody else. So even just putting something like that out and working with Vita to put that on their patient spotlight page.
And I know that can be really scary for a lot of people. Like, I remember being terrified to write out my story the first time
right.
and share that with people. So maybe keeping in mind, like, how many people that you might be helping can help you get through it. And also, like you said, it can be very therapeutic, too.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
And even, I don't know if you guys have been following a lot of what Vita's been doing the last couple of weeks, but they've had kind of a series of different posts going on with the Did You Knows that have different facts about the way our vestibular systems work that you may never even thought about. I mean, I'll be honest, I didn't even know I had a vestibular system before it all went to, that is a good question. Did you know about your vestibular system really until you got sick? Because I didn't, and I had never even heard of vestibular migraine. I was like, but I don't have headaches. Like, what?
Right.
And then you just learn a whole new thing about that. So there are things that Vita are posting out there, the Did You Knows. They have a series of All Can Fall, which is the theme that Alicia was talking about. Mm-hmm. And they recently shared an infographic about All Can Fall. And it kind of just talks about that you don't just have to be, you know, like an elderly person just to have that happen to you. You know, you could be, I was 27 years old when I first got diagnosed. So
yeah. And I was 30, I think, so.
Yeah. So there are a lot of different things that Vita's putting out there that you can definitely share on your own social media that, you know, if you're not comfortable to write anything like we were talking about, just share those things on your social media.
Mm-hmm.
Something else you can do, too, if you're kind of involved in your community, is even reach out to your local newspaper or TV station, because, you know, a lot of times the media likes to do, like, human interest pieces, especially when it's around something like this, like Balance Awareness Week. So, you know, reach out to, if you follow them on Twitter or Facebook, reach out to them and let them know about your story and kind of let them know like what Balance Awareness Week is about next week.
Yeah, another idea, Vita has brochures that you can get in touch with them online and have them send those to you. So info@vestibular.org is an email if you want a direct contact with Vita, but also there's areas on their websites where you can request information and bring that into some of your physicians. So let's say you have a physician that doesn't understand what you're going through and you've researched online and they say vestibular migraine isn't a real diagnosis. You can take some of these brochures to them and say, hey, this is what I know and this is what I've been reading about, you know? And so maybe that'll educate them more on vestibular disorders. So your ENTs, your neurologist, your physical therapist, all good places to start. I know that I saw several ENTs and neurologists that didn't know what vestibular migraine was or never once mentioned it to me during my time trying to be diagnosed. And then there are other ENTs and neurologists who know exactly what it is and they specialize in it and they're great resources. So just saying go to an ENT or a neurologist, it's kind of difficult because you really need someone who specializes and understands it. So sharing those articles can be a great resource for them too. Also bringing Vita's educational articles to your local senior center. A lot of seniors deal with vestibular disorders, and it, you know, that can help them get help and understand what's going on with them. I know my grandma developed a vestibular disorder as she got older after a concussion, and so and there was no one in her area to really help her be diagnosed. So that can help raise more awareness as well. Finally, another thing is to get involved with your local legislators. So this was something I did. Vita had a tweet format that you could tweet out to your local congressman or woman and just kind of urge them to make Balance Awareness Week an official week. But also another thing to do is just let them know about vestibular disorders. Let them know why we're participating in Balance Awareness Week and what that means to you. Any awareness that we can get in the public eye is wonderful.
Absolutely. And think about also when you're doing any of these things, especially on social media, to make sure that you're hashtagging Balance Awareness Week, because as Alicia was saying, you know, the more awareness that we even make around the Awareness Week, you know, that might become a lot more notable to people.
Yeah.
So just hashtagging Balance Awareness Week and all can fall with anything that you post, share. Like I said, you can find all the content on Vita's site. I mean, you can even look at our sites if you're ever looking for anything that you relate to. I mean, there's a lot of ambassadors out there who also have websites that you can refer to. And also, I don't know if you've created, there's also ways that you can just actually bring money back to Vita by donating and creating fundraising pages, just to get your friends and family or maybe your local community involved, because Vita is a small organization. They really survive off of volunteers and donations. So anything that you can do to kind of help, I mean, think about the resources that Vita gave you when you first got diagnosed. I mean, it helped me out a lot. And just to know that, you know, the more that you donate and help out the organization, you know, that's going to help all of us, essentially.
Yeah.
So.
And maybe you're not utilizing their resources enough. Like Vita has, like I said, the info@vestibular.org. You can get in touch with them directly if you need assistance for someone in your area or if they maybe have a recommendation. But there's also a directory where you can research vestibular therapy centers, support groups in your area. There are so many ways that they can help you more than just education. So be sure to check out the website and see if there's any different areas that you can get involved in as well if you need that extra support.
Yeah, I mean, I can just say too, on top of being an ambassador, but just volunteering for something that, you know, we deal with this on a daily basis. Like this is our life. So, I mean, I'm very passionate about it. And I feel like after just being involved with Vita, it's been really cool just the connections I've made and just this, like, even meeting everybody in this community. Like, it's just really good to know you're not alone.
Oh, yeah. Like, some of my closest friends have become people who I've met because of vestibular migraine, like Kayla. It brings so many people together. And I guess that's the one positive about dealing with such a horrible disorder is you feel very isolated. And so finding someone else who understands exactly what you're going through is everything, and it can get you out of that dark space. And like, we can text each other like, hey, how's your head today? Oh my gosh, this thunderstorm is killing me. Or you know, situations like that. And she'll know exactly what I'm going through, and I'll know exactly what she's going through. And that's sometimes rare when you're dealing with vestibular disorder.
Well, it helps we're both in Dallas, because I feel like we know a storm's coming before we actually hear. So,
but 69 million Americans have vestibular disorders. It's certainly more prevalent than, you know, even celiac disease, which you hear about all the time. So don't feel like you're alone. It's just, we need that awareness. You know, think of all the people talking about gluten-free and celiac and everything like that. That's the kind of buzz we need to create for vestibular disorders.
Right. So those are kind of the things that you can do to get involved. Someone actually wrote, Abby just wrote that you can do birthday Facebook fundraisers. Yes.
Oh, that's great.
I do that every year, and it's honestly right before Balance Awareness Week. So I'm just getting my little extra in there right before it. So that's a great idea, and that's definitely something to do. So anyway, this Balance Awareness Week for us,
We're talking about what we're doing.
Yeah, what we're doing. Maybe you can piggyback off of it, and, you know, if you want to be involved, give us a shout out. I know that I'll be continuing just to write about it on my blog and just sharing any tips and tricks, you know, just based on how I'm feeling. That's usually what I do, and just to kind of bring awareness, you know, around having a vestibular disorder.
Yeah, and like I said, I tweeted at our representative, Colin Allred, already about vestibular disorders, which he did not respond to, so I think I'm going to have to get back on that.
Well, Mark Cuban liked my tweet on Twitter,
Mark Cuban. Yeah, so Mark Cuban actually tweeted about the Dizzy and Vertigo Center, and who helped him with his vestibular disorder, and how helpful they were. And
I was gonna say, even just retweeting what he tweeted, I mean, he is such, like, everyone knows who Mark Cuban is, and the fact that he is like a face that people can recognize that had something that we, that's similar to all of us, you know, that's a big deal.
Yeah, for sure. I am also, so Kayla and I together, we are also leading a Miles for Migraine group next month. It's going to be Wednesday, October the 9th. In Dallas. So if you're a Dallas local,
That's right, Dave. Yep, October the 9th.
But it's going to be a monthly meeting that we're going to start for people with not only migraine, but vestibular migraine. So an opportunity for us all to be together. We're going to have some doctors speak from UT Southwestern, as well as do fun events like mindfulness meetings, restorative yoga, specifically for vestibular disorders, vestibular migraine. So we're going to start that once a month, and hopefully have a little local support group here.
So shout out to everybody. And if you're like in the DFW area and you want to join, or like Lisa, who just wrote on this, I know you're in Houston, you want to come up.
Yeah, come on in, and we'll start, this is a month notice, but once this gets up and going, we'll really start talking about it and sharing it, so you can sign up through those websites, and we'll share those links on our pages, too. What else? Oh, so if you guys know me, I work on the Dizzy Cook, and I'm currently writing a book. It's a cookbook for migraine diet recipes, but there is going to be an entire section on vestibular migraine. So I talk about my story, my journey, tips for being diagnosed. I have a whole section in there with Dr. Edward Cho from House Clinic in LA, where he goes through and describes different symptoms that we can experience, even some of the less common symptoms that we experience, like Alice in Wonderland syndrome, you know, things that aren't always talked about. I talk about how I got help and kind of my journey to feeling better. And so I think that's going to be really helpful for people with vestibular migraine because there aren't very many books and resources out there. So that's actually, it's going to be out next year in February 2020, but it's available for pre-order on Amazon now. But I'm hoping it really helps bring some awareness to vestibular disorders and vestibular migraine.
Yeah, that's really great. Sheldon just wrote that he posted awareness posters at the Miami VA hospital and outpatient clinic.
Oh, awesome. Awesome idea. Yeah, that's perfect.
Right. I'm seeing, just watching, reading the comments as they come through. Okay. I saw David wanted to know if we saw his comment. Hi, David. great. Yeah. I mean, there's many things that you can do too. I mean, for an example, I work in marketing, and after I got sick, I had to quit my job, and I just started doing that full-time freelancing, and I've actually gotten involved with companies that are, like, their goal is to help people with migraine, migraine. So, you know, if you have a set of skills and it can help just in general, like, the community, I mean, that's kind of stuff that you can do, too. So,
yeah,
I'm just passionate about helping people any way I can and just raising awareness, and during next week, you will definitely see, you will see both of us online and sharing, and you know, if anyone has any questions, go ahead and, you know, feel free to put them in the comment box here. And also just keep sharing with us what it is that you've already done, like what Sheldon was just saying about posting flyers and stuff. Or if you have any cool creative ideas that we didn't even talk about, like if there's anything that you've done that's been successful.
Or if there's something you want to see us do, us talk about, or something you would like to see Vita talk about, write them now in the comments and we'll kind of go over them.
Yeah.
I don't know how many people out there are interested in becoming Vita ambassadors, but that's something both of us are, and I know many of our friends are as well. Like some of our friends in the UK will probably tune in and see this tomorrow. but you can be an ambassador from anywhere in the world. Vita just asks you to sign up, and you can kind of talk about what you want to volunteer for. So it can be as small as, you know, making a few phone calls every month. Sometimes I'll do new member calls. So I will get a sheet with like two or three names, and they'll have me reach out to new members who have donated to the Vestibular Disorder Association. I'll just kind of welcome them to the group, point them in the right direction. So, you know, if you're at home and you can't really be on a computer a lot, which is totally understandable, you know, maybe that's something you can do is make some phone calls, or they can help you with some ideas on how to even be an ambassador when you don't have a website. So it's definitely something that is really exciting to be a part of, and we enjoy it, and we hope more people will start to join as well.
Yeah, I mean, I think even since we started, it's just grown, it's blown up. So it's exciting to see, and I think it's exciting for Vita too, just to see how many people are really wanting to get involved and just, you know, are willing just to share their stories and just help others.
Yeah. Yeah. So I think they just said to become, start filling out a volunteer application. So you can find all that on vestibular.org, and it's really easy to do.
Yeah. I think Vita also, if you want some Balance Awareness Week posters, you can go ahead and contact Vita for those too. They can send you anything that you need if you want to get on their mailing list. I mean their email list and stuff too.
Yeah.
So for any kind of handouts that you need, contact Vita.
Yeah.
So, all right, guys. Well, I think that's all we got. Like I said, go ahead and leave if you need any answers to anything, or if you have any great feedback on stuff that you've been doing in your local community. We'd love to hear it. And just keep the conversation going. I hope to see you all online next week.
Yeah. Thank you for tuning in.
Bye, guys.
Bye.